factors affecting the rate of chemical reaction. Surface area. Temperature. Catalyst. Concentration. Surface area.
In this experiment, I will show you how surface area affects the rate of chemical reaction. So we need two glasses, clear, two tablets of vitamin C, but one is whole and one is pulverized. So this is the comparison of the surface area. And we need water. Are you ready? Okay. So first, we'll put the water in the glasses. Almost full. For the two glasses. Okay. So now we will see the rate of the reaction. Okay, so we'll put this simultaneously. Okay, ready? Okay, so you see the reaction of the vitamin C. The pulverized one is immediately reacted, it's immediately dissolved. Unlike the whole, it still is being dissolved. See, there's still the cool one. While this one, it's already stopped reacting.
Temperature.
In this experiment, I will show you how temperature affects the rate of reaction. So we need two clear glasses, two effervescent vitamin C tablet, cold water, and hot water. So let's start the experiment. Are you excited?
Yes.
Okay. So first, let's put the cold water in our first glass. So this is cold water. And the next one is hot water. I will use a spoon so that it will prevent the glass from breaking. Because if it's too hot, the glass might break. Okay. So, now it doesn't break. Are you ready? So this is cold water and this is hot water. Now see. Okay. You see how the cold water and the hot water reacted with the vitamin C tablet? The cold water is still reacting while the hot water is almost finished. So the higher the temperature, the faster the rate of reaction.
Catalyst.
In this experiment, I will show you how a catalyst affects the rate of chemical reaction. So we need two clear glasses, hydrogen peroxide. This is 6% hydrogen peroxide from the pharmacy. If you have a more concentrated hydrogen peroxide, like 30%, that will be good. But be careful on using this hydrogen peroxide. And we also need yeast. Okay, so let's start the experiment. First, we need 2 tablespoons of hydrogen peroxide in each glasses. 1, 2. This one. too. So as you can see, when hydrogen peroxide is at this state, it is already disintegrating. But you cannot see it because it's really slow. Now we have the yeast. This yeast will act as the catalyst, meaning it will speed up the rate of reaction of the hydrogen peroxide. So let's put 1/4 teaspoon. So this is a 1/2 teaspoon measuring spoon. So I will just put it half. So this will be 1/4 teaspoon. So without a catalyst, this hydrogen peroxide is already disintegrating, but very slow. And this one, we will put a catalyst and we'll see what will happen. Okay, so now, what can you see? The hydrogen peroxide with a catalyst disintegrate faster, meaning the oxygen is already being released very fast. See? So this is how a catalyst speeds up the rate of reaction. Concentration. In this experiment, I will show you how concentration affects the rate of chemical reaction. So we need, in this experiment, we need 3 glasses, which is clear. I have here warm water to dissolve our yeast. I have here hydrogen peroxide. And I have here water at room temperature. So the first step two and 1 tablespoon of water at room temperature. For the third glass, this is the least concentrated, I will put 1 tablespoon of hydrogen peroxide and 2 tablespoons of water. And 2 tablespoons of water. So, yes, and I need to add another ingredient, which is the dishwashing soap. So, our experiment will be more bubbly. So, I'll put maybe 1/2 tablespoon. Okay, just put it here. There. And as you can see, I use a tray because maybe later after this will react, it will be messy. So you need a tray. So I repeat, this first one is least concentrated, which is 1 tablespoon of hydrogen peroxide and 2 tablespoon water. This one is 2 tablespoon hydrogen peroxide and 1 tablespoon water. And this one is more concentrated, which is 3 tablespoon of hydrogen peroxide. Okay, so let's start the experiment. So I'll be calling here my assistant Joyce to help me in pouring the yeast. So I will count to 3, and this one you will put here, I will put here.
Okay.
One. Use your another hand.
Hello.
Okay. So 1, 2, 3. So can you see the reaction? Which one is the fastest? So this one, and then next is this one. And then the last one is this one. So this is the least concentrated and this is the more concentrated. So as you can see, about the time of the rate of reaction. So the more concentrated the chemicals are, the faster the rate of reaction.